हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मैक मिश्रा चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एंड लर्न वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज़ द इफेक्ट ऑफ द पीएच ऑन द कोरोजन रेट। सो हाउ कोरोजन रेट ऑफ मेटल, स्पेसिफिकली कार्बन स्टील, वेरीज विद द पीएच ऑफ द सोल्यूशन। हाउ वी कैन प्रिडिक्ट और एस्टिमेट द कोरोजन रेट, we will learn in this lecture series. So let's start. First of all, what is pH? We'll understand the basic understanding. So pH is a measure of concentration of hydrogen ion. So how much concentration of hydrogen ion in my system, it is measured by the pH. So okay, so the pH, how you will calculate? So you can calculate the pH by minus log to the base 10 of hydrogen plus ion. Means hydrogen plus ion, if pH is 5, then what will be the number of hydrogen plus ion concentration? That will be 10 to the power 5. So this is the concentration of the H plus ion in the solution, 10 to the power 5, if my pH is 5. So pH is calculated by this formula. Now from where this pH came? So P stand for the general word potenge. Potenge means power, and H is hydrogen. So pH is a abbreviation of power of hydrogen. So how much the power of hydrogen, how much hydrogen is there in the system, is measured by the pH. So if my pH is 7, if pH is measured on scale of 1 to 14, okay, so pH is measured from scale of 0 to 14, 7 is regarded as neutral pH, that is of pure water. And if we are reducing, going this side, we are going for the acidic side of acidic side, and if we are going towards the 14, we are going from the for basic side. Sorry. So acidic pH, neutral pH is 7, that is of pure water. pH 6 is milk or healthy lake. pH 5 is in bananas, green rain. pH 4 is acid rain, acidic lake. pH 3 is orange juice, soda. pH 2 is lemon vinegar. These are the basic examples. pH 1 is sulfuric acid, pH 0 is battery acid. And when we are going for the higher side, seawater having pH 8, baking soda pH 9, milk of magnesia pH 10, ammonia pH 11, soapy water pH 12, bleach, and pH 14 is liquid drain cleaner. So this is the basic scale from 0 to 14, 7 is a neutral, and going toward the lower side is acidic, and going toward higher side is basic. So this is the basic understanding of the pH. Okay, so here if my pH is 1, means H plus concentration will be 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power 3. These are the minus log of 10 to the power 6, means pH 6, pH 9. Okay, so here we are acidic side. Here we are going for the basic side. In the acidic side, increasing hydrogen ion, H plus ion will get increased in acidic side, and in basic side, OH minus, which we are calling hydroxide ion, will get increased. Okay, so we have the scale of 0 to 14, and pH plus means concentration of hydrogen ion plus concentration of hydroxide ion comes to 14, means pH plus POH is equal to 14. If I have the concentration of H plus ion, I can calculate the concentration of OH ion also by reducing it to 14. Now, how this corrosion works in acidic? So, in acids, we seen that the hydrogen ion will be much more higher in the acids. So, what it will do? So, it will basically faster, it will increase the corrosion rate by making the reaction more fast. Means the iron will readily release the electron, because and this electron will be reduced, is accepted by this H plus ion and is converted into the H2. Okay, so the reaction will get increased in the presence of the acid, because the protective layer which iron has formed that not remain stable. So Fe atom at the metal surface dissolves into the moisture film, leaving the negative charge metal in the metal. So iron will convert into Fe2 plus and leaving the two electron, and that electron get absorbed by the hydrogen. And if we have oxygen in the system, the corrosion rate will much more aggravate, because O2 plus this, it will give 4 electron plus OH minus. And so that's how this metal iron get corroded in the presence of the acid. More H plus ion, faster will be the reaction, and the film, protective film, will be less stable and get dissolved. Now we can calculate the corrosion rate based on the pH. So pH 7, this is my pH 7, this is neutral, okay, and here this side OH minus concentration ppm, OH minus, or we can say NaOH, and is this side is HCl concentration in ppm. So if we are going 7 to 8 9 10, my NaOH means OH minus concentration ppm is increasing. Here OH minus concentration is 440 400 4000. So here OH minus concentration is increasing, means caustic is increasing. NaOH is increasing. Here this side acid is increasing, means HCl or H plus ion is increasing. Okay, so the pH here approx 8 point something to 12, this pH range is the lowest pH range, lowest pH having least this corrosion rate. So in this pH range we can see the least corrosion rates. Okay, so when HCl ppm will increase, the corrosion rate will drastically increase, and this pH range the corrosion rate will be stable, and then again when OH minus concentration will increase, the pH pH will increase, the corrosion rate again start increasing. So that's how we can predict the corrosion rate on certain pH. We can predict on that this pH how will be my corrosion rate, and this is approx at 25 degree centigrade. So basically we have seen for water, the most stable range means where the corrosion rate will be least will be pH from 8.5 to 12.7. in this pH range the corrosion will be least, means this is the minimum corrosion which is happening. If we are reducing the pH, then 8.5 the corrosion rate will increase. If we are increasing the pH above 12.7, then again corrosion rate get increased. So we need to find out where the stable film get formed in which pH range. So approximately 6 to 12 there will be stable film get formed, but that will be more stable, much more stable in between 8.5 to 12.7. but here in this range also we will see little higher corrosion rate, but below 6 there will be a drastically high corrosion rates. So this is my 7 neutral pH, here this side acidic, this side alkaline, and this is my corrosion rate. So based on the pH we can calculate the corrosion rates. So hope you have enjoyed this lecture, you have basic understood the pH, POH, and how it's affect the corrosion rate. So friends, this is a lecture series on corrosion and this is to be continued. If you find this video useful, please share with your friends and the social media. Thank you very much.